Hey, we're doing the Lions rebuild again. So, we're gonna play against the Steelers in this game. We're gonna play up against the Steelers this time. And then probably sim a couple more games. And then we'll see what happens. So yeah, we're gonna play against the Steelers, then probably sim some games. And then maybe in the next episode we can finish up the season. You would definitely be able to win. 16 seasons, but it's 17. We might also have to do the playoffs so we can finish out the regular season in the next day, maybe. So we don't care about the weekly strategy. Yeah, if you look in us at the division, we're 5-3, and we're tied with the Vikings. So what we need to do is we kind of need the Vikings to start losing, and we need to start winning some more. Yeah, whatever that's how we're gonna describe it. So, yeah, we're just gonna play against Steelers, and if we win, then skip weekly strategy, play full game. We kind of need to win our next games and not. All right, we can make them look bad. Yeah, I don't like that one. I'm gonna say we're gonna do that one probably. Or that's worse. We got a worse one. Let me make sure. Ooh. Steelers do not have good uniforms. I think this was the worst one though. What is that? Alright, let's go. Let's see, can we win? Hope, this is kind of an important one. We kind of need to win.
Since the turn of the century, Detroit's been unable to get a single win against Pittsburgh. The Lions look to bury the past. Next on EA Sports.
And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback.
All right. Wow, these uniforms look bad.
On first down, it's Roethlisberger. And they get to him with a
good start. Oh yeah, and also I signed, there are some really good free agents, so I got Mark Ingram and some other guy that was like 76 overall. Turns out they're not starters either way, but they're close, so.
Throwing on second and
long. Yeah, getting a couple plays. Yeah! Nice start.
DeMarcus Walker.
Two sacks for deep. DeMarcus Walker.
Second sack of the afternoon. Well, someone came to play today.
No, there's no doubt about it. We heard about it all week, didn't we? Especially when we visited practice. He thought he had a good matchup in front of him.
All right. Well, good start off for the game.
And they'll hit him for a loss as
4th and 33.
2 yard line. A loss of a yard, and it brings up fourth. The Steelers send out their punter now. And no room for error here as his first punt comes from deep in his own end zone.
Yeah.
39 yards on the punt. Just
we can see the home team intended pass target. That sounds really OP. Alright, let me see if I can find the Y shell cross. I didn't change your offensive scheme to make us fit it better. If it's not in anymore, that'd be kind of disappointing.
That's caught by the big tight end, T.J. Hockenson.
Down to 22.
Get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. 25 yards that time. And this one goes nowhere, losing yardage back at the 22. Officially, it's a 1 yard loss. That's going to bring up.
Oh, yeah, that's when TJ Watson got injured. I kind of forgot about that. That could be a problem.
Here to Swift. He is taken down at the 21 after a short gain of two. So a look here.
Yeah,
at the
we have a lot of players out for
the game.
You don't need to show that every
day. Tell us the same thing every time, don't they? Next man up.
No excuses. Be ready to play. That's the mantra of every organization. The key is having guys on the roster who are.
And the ball is.
Wow! but I was covering up the ball too.
We know he's got the speed.
Every time I run it, that happens. I was covering up the ball and I was starting to slide, and then he gets hit and fumbles. Rex sucks. He's definitely not a keeper quarterback. Quarterbacks fumble too much in Madden. Like, that's another gameplay complaint. Like, if a quarterback runs it in real life, they almost never fumble in Madden. Fumble every play. Even when I slide. I was starting to slide and got hit. Stupid.
Roethlisberger on the draw. It's Harris. And for a
well, if we can get another stop, then it's fine.
Defense drops him behind the line of scrimmage.
I guess our defense seems to be pretty good. So, I mean, if our offense sucks and our defense is good enough, then it'll be good. This time they have some open people, but. Nope! Oh, come on! We got ripped off. They look like soccer uniforms, these ones they have. They don't look like. Those look more like soccer uniforms.
Well, one way or the other, you knew they'd have to push the ball downfield on third and long. But I'm not sure the defense is expecting to push it that far downfield. Their math didn't add up, but it certainly did for the offense.
Harris die.
Now the stiff arm created some space initially, but he's taken down not long after. A minimal gain as we tick down inside of a minute remaining in the opening quarter. Trying to pick it up on the ground with Harris. And he will be very close to a first down, but I see the close.
Come on, don't go for it. Don't go. They're going to go for it. Yeah. Makes sense. It's a 47. They passing it? There's no way. They don't even have a running back. Who's their intended target? I lost that. Nice pick. You're really good at getting picks, apparently. All
right.
Now let's make up for the stupid fumble play we had. And maybe not get, like, the worst play possible called. Stop our runs.
And he's able to get out to the 32, brought down there.
If our offense is good enough, if our defense, if we just don't allow any points in defense, then it doesn't matter how good our offense is. Our offense can suck, and it doesn't matter.
Flush out.
Come on, slide. Go out. We're not fumbling.
Before he's out of bounds. Nothing open downfield. He keeps it himself for 11 and a first down. To throw is gone.
Dang it. It sucks. No. All right. That was not
second down.
Okay. Let's not do that again.
Here's Goff.
Okay, that was not. He was open. He just got pressured stupidly. Come on! Our entire offense was in front of him. I didn't even catch him. That was stupid.
That's a tough spot as a quarterback draws you running.
Offense is terrible.
You see what can happen when you do try to get rid of it with pressure.
Yeah, how about the pressure coming without them having to blitz? That's when you know things are clicking for your defense. And the end result, they end up gaining 6 points.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. And
yeah, hurry, come on.
Touchback as that sails over the end line.
Stupid play, like.
The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. 5-3, their record at the halfway point. And you have to imagine that there are folks saying,
stop,
hey, if we do
growling at each other and stuff.
10-6 and we're a playoff team.
I do think, though, that they have a couple things working against them. And number one, the schedule, that's going to toughen up a bit because they've got some division games down the stretch, and those are always difficult. Number two, you know they've got to stay healthy. That's the key to get
it. Yeah, we do have some division games.
But they've got a shot at it.
That's the problem.
It's his first catch.
We're going to only fit one game per episode, and we're trying to fit in a couple games per episode. I really should save this game and just play the original game, but it's not what I'm excited to do this episode. I really don't think this. I really should not have done that. I should have skimmed this game and then played some of our divisional games, like the important ones against the Vikings. I can't pick the game to do that too. So.
3 yards on the pickup there, but they've only got it back to 3rd and 10.
Well, he hasn't made much of an impact in the running game thus far, and after that last run, not much is going to change in that area.
He hasn't been able to get anything going, and really the offensive line not helping him much. And that is incomplete. Oh, he had a defender right there with him to force that to the ground.
We should be destroying them.
NFC's Pro Bowl punter a year ago, Jack Fox.
We're losing, even though we should be up by like 2 or 3 touchdowns
deep,
right now.
Ray McLeod calls for the fair catch, makes the fair catch just inside the 15-yard line. They call it 38 yards on the punt, no return. And the Steelers are going to take over first and 10 deep in their own territory. Now a pass that's taken in by Smith-Schuster. A gain of 6 there on first.
If you're running out route, it's likely you're going to end up near the sideline. And what did we just see there?
Toe tap.
You got it. The benefits of practice. Toe tapping, foot dragging, picking it up, and making sure it was a catch.
And he still has yet to get
on
track first half.
Pick six.
We need that. It'll be a loss of a full 3 yards there, and it also
make
brings up third down.
Throw it. Or just two good quarterbacks. That's not
He's
it.
He's got a man open. It's Chase Claypool. And he'll have this past the 30 prior to going out of bounds. Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down. 2 minutes on the clock, second quarter, 7-0 ball game.
Yeah.
A reminder,
I say that we never use Jared Goff one of these franchises again.
In Orlando, he'll have all the stats and scores from games in progress around the NFL.
The best multitasker in the business, the coach.
And he's taken down right at the 45-yard line. A good pickup there, a 22. On first and 10, Roethlisberger.
Zach. Yes.
And he'll be hit.
Good enough.
He releases it, and that'll fall incomplete. Chase Claypool, the intended target.
All right, at least we started off with the second half.
To throw again is Roethlisberger. It's brought in by Harris. That helps the completion percentage, but not much else. And now it's 3rd and 10. From the gun, it's Roethlisberger. Now Ben hit, and he
all right.
The football. It's loose.
Wouldn't be better if we picked up the fumble, but it still stopped the clock, right?
We were able to keep the football, but now
nope.
Down,
I thought it stopped
so
the clock.
I do think, though, they're going
to... Yeah, that's the one other thing Madden does, is that it doesn't run the clock after the play, but then it does. So there's a lot of times where it runs the clock, and you didn't think it would. So now, we would have had 50 seconds, now you have 20. So.
All
right, come on, just let it bounce it. We're not going to try to return that.
And that one hits a little too close to the goal line.
We've got like 3 plays to score.
For a touchback. Tyler Lockett trotting onto the field, getting set for this next drive. You better believe that he's well aware he has 0 catches right now, and they're losing, so he's probably a little hungry.
And you know the guys on defense are aware as well, and they're really excited.
That's not what I would
catches,
think.
But they're also worried.
But,
because a lot of times, that's like the
no,
ticking
no,
time
maybe
bomb.
He is hungry.
The longer you hold him down, when he finally explodes, look.
And now
maybe
we'll
just throw another dumb kick. And then they'll outrun our entire team somehow, even though our entire team was right in front of them.
Get the football in very good field position late in this first half. So good starting field position for them here as they come up first and 10, right at the 50-yard line. He'll find Smith-Schuster, that's complete.
Oh, whatever. Oh, they have him kick a 57-yard field and end it out. Come on, no way they make this. No way they make this. Yeah, no, they missed.
That's leaking to the right, and
he would have made it if he was accurate. I didn't think he had enough power or the accuracy.
Abbreviated halftime show as we get rolling to quarter
I don't
three.
Do that. Oh, whatever, it isn't bad.
Okay, coach, appreciate
all right.
A one touchdown.
We need to score on this drive, and then our defense
in the
stay up. Pretty sure this is like the oldest stadium right now.
And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end.
All right. No more. No more stupid picks.
The Lions
that's probably going
to
happen. But
it's been a tight game to this point. What do they need to do, Charles, to break
try to have that not happen?
And take the lead?
Or to have that exactly happen? Or dumb drops, you know? That,
I think the defense is saying back to them.
That would also be good to not have.
Some first downs, put some drives together. Give us a little bit of a break here. If we can get some rest, we'll play even better for you. And oh, by the way, pay off a few of those drives with some points, too.
Well, that'll be incomplete. Well, it took a shot as he let that go. And it's going to bring up a third down. An important play right here, third and 10.
And I would expect pressure here.
And yet
come
again,
on!
Is intercepted.
The Steelers' secondary is not this good. We drop picks half time. They do not catch everything.
So here's a
the receiver's
head at the 38.
This is ridiculous.
They'll try the right side with Harris. And he'll take this one down to the 36. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8. Now Roethlisberger. Throw that side complete to Smith-Schuster. And they move this all the way down to the 9. A very solid gain of 27. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he maneuvers his way down to the 3-yard line. A good run of 6 yards there. Gets him closer to the goal line with second down coming up. Again, it's Harris.
So dumb. We should be destroying them. But because of dumb kicks, then we're losing 14-0. We should be destroying them. Die.
So the toss play effective even down here near the goal line.
I'm gonna try to injure their kicker. Best thing we can do right now.
And that your practice can gain a little bit of an advantage. And when they do, foot race to the pylon, and this time. He had the speed to win that race.
After the roughing penalty on the PAT, they'll kick off from 15 yards further upfield. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. A chance for us again to look at this Pittsburgh defense.
Now they have all the momentum.
They forced 4 turnovers now in that last possession, most recently the interception.
I'd love to be in charge of their highlight.
And they have the worst camera angle of all time.
This game,
I do not see what's going on.
One sequence.
It's actually not as bad as the camera angle as like this is. Not good.
Of a yard there to start out. That leads to a 7-11.
Did not do anything.
He'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line. 2 runs in a row, but only
somebody
2 yards to show for it. Well, the terrible towels here at Heinz Field, out in full force. Here's 3rd and long.
Yo, this is not.
This is intercepted for the 4th time today.
Yeah. It's not even the quarterback's fault. This is Madden being dumb.
When he went on the move there and started rolling out, I thought there was a window, but that window closed quickly. Intercepted.
There was a window. Madden just being stupid. And now he can't tackle.
You don't get enough on a throw when you're on the move as opposed to setting your feet and stepping into one. That may have been the case there, and the defense certainly benefited.
Trey Flowers there on the tackle. Again, it's Harris on 2nd down. And he'll take this down just shy of the 25-yard line. 3 yards is half of what they needed. Now can they get the other 3 here on 3rd down? Roethlisberger. Over the middle, complete. It's Harris. And he will have a Steelers 1st down, I do believe. Yes, he's got it by about a yard there on 3rd and 3. To throw here, Roethlisberger.
No. Yes!
And this is going to be intercepted.
All right, we need to find like a meta play, or else we're dead. That's not what I meant to call, but
just
need to not throw a pick.
You're a nickel with 5 defensive backs on the field.
And that's exactly why you have those 5 DBs out there. You want extra speed on the field. Guys who have
right.
Ball skills and understand what the passing can do. It gives them a chance to react and make a play on the football.
Where's washout cross? Does it not exist anymore?
Oh, that was a nice job there. Quarterback to receiver reading the pressure that was brought. They both knew it was going to open up the middle of the field. Nice little shake and bake at the line of scrimmage, got right into his route.
It.
And the quarterback hit him in stride, and he was able to run free after the catch.
Go try this. It has a similar route.
Quickly all the way up at the 40-yard line.
Come on. How do you get it? How do you get it? How do you get it? Dumb. I've been spamming height for like the last 10 seconds and it would not work. He's just standing still. Yeah, that was Madden's fault, not me. I was just trying to call the play and just standing there.
There was no hurried movements there, right? No up tempo at all. Clock just ran out. I think he was as surprised as maybe his bench was.
No, I was telling him to hike it and he was just standing there.
So a little bit of a stiffer challenge now. First and 15 following the delay of game. Goff now looking to throw.
Come on!
And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down.
All right, whatever. This is sort of second down.
Dropping the hammer off the edge.
Not fair.
Chalk that up as their first sack in this
if
game.
If we pass, nobody's open. If we actually hit somebody open, we get sacked.
Probably not as much exultation in that sack as what took us so long. Because when you get four the previous week, you're counting on continuing that momentum. Gosh. They didn't get that done in the first half.
They're not on here.
Let's see now if they start to bring even more.
Are there any plays that I know that almost always work? No. There were no plays I see. That was not.
Now in Pittsburgh.
Okay, that was not delay of game. Cool.
For this third quarter of action, we'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Back now here on EA Sports.
All right, I saw a play.
It's the Lions trailing, but with possession of the football as we get set to
this
bring
like
the
same
play.
So once we get somebody open, we always have to. Or never mind! We're good. Underthrow it, and it's going to get picked off either way.
It's Devin Bush, the linebacker, who picks it. And he's going to get this one to the 23-yard line. Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. He gets it complete to him.
Nope.
And he will reach the 5-yard line before going out of bounds. That one good for 17 yards. And now they've got it first and goal. A good chance now to put this game on ice. This is first and goal. Here's Roethlisberger. Toward the pylon, caught. They'll contain him to just 4. Second down. Harris, and they'll bring him down after just a short pickup. Calling a gain of a yard as they get a little bit closer here. It's third and goal. Roethlisberger will throw.
Yeah, not
open man is
Johnson. Well, he's going to score as fast as possible right now. It's going to work.
His fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Steelers are closing in on a third straight win as they widen the gap further here in the fourth quarter. Extra point put through by Boswell. And that makes the score 21 to zip. Boswell now to kick it away after the touchdown. This one taken just inside the 10. Oh, a good return up past the 30. And a good effort on the return there. Gets him across the 30, up to the 33. So here come the Lions now. They were coming off the extra
week
of
rest,
but this team started sluggish and it really didn't get any
better from
there. Trailing big here in this fourth quarter. Trying to shake off the interception.
Maybe it can go wrong. He's running to our offensive lineman again.
Another throw there off.
A player has no awareness.
Receptions, things just haven't been.
There's no awareness, no catching.
Anything's going on out there, CD.
They have nothing. Even our good players can never get open.
He's been coached really
how do you and we drop it?
To not show that he's having
quarter play. You know, gotta drop it.
No matter what, you keep throwing the football with confidence. But we're not seeing a confident thrower right now. He's off balance, the passing game's off balance, and the defense is taking advantage.
Throwing on third. Go.
He dropped it on
this defense was
wide open. Drop. He got hit a little bit, but still, he gets hit a little bit. You don't drop it like you got destroyed. You drop, you get, you maybe do. And he dropped it again. Three drops in a row. Three drops in a row. That's how we're going to end off this game. Three drops in a row.
Excellent field position.
Our team sucked.
This stage of the game,
how did I win the first two games?
Three scores,
they weren't even close.
They needed a push.
apparently, all pro is a completely different day game on offense than defense is the Lions. On all pro, nobody's open, or if somebody is open, you get sacked. Running does nothing. Your offense, your defense is usually pretty good, but sometimes you just mess up and allow 30-yard runs like that.
It's a Pittsburgh first down, a gain of 13.
Well, I think there's any question, Brandon, at this stage, the stop troops, the defensive guys, they got to use their three timeouts here. They've got to stop them and get the ball back.
Yeah, if you're in that 2-3 score deficit window that they're in now, you got to get it ASAP.
Yeah, no doubt about it. Stop them, use your timeouts. Easier to move the ball on offense without timeouts than to stop them on defense without using them.
So the Steelers with a football as we get you reset. And you'd have to figure they're just looking to burn these final 2 minutes away and get out of here with a victory. And again, the run defense stout this time. He maybe gets back to the line of scrimmage, but no more. Maybe a gain of a yard that time, but yeah, from the spot, actually no gain. So third and long. On third down, here's Harris. He's to the 10, and finally wrestled down at the 8-yard line. The Lions now going to use the second of their timeouts, and they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground, and they'll get this from the 8 to the 5. Pickup of 3. Give him 3 on the gain there, second and goal. On the give, this is Harris. And the Lions quickly now going to use the last of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 35 seconds left to go. Can they convert another here on third and goal? And they'll indeed take a knee.
Well, that's the play you work on each and every week. Your offense taking a knee at the end means you've won the ball game.
They're not even going to take a defensive effort. Get in the position.
Pitching a shutout.
Or they are.
They're going to feel really good about themselves. A big goose egg on the scoreboard. Nice job defensively.
Yeah, I said dinner on the defensive coordinator tonight.
So this one in the win column.
Somehow, we actually got a lot of points out of that. Somehow. You know, that was our worst game. That might be my worst Madden game of all time. Yeah, I think we're screwed. Boost awareness for offensive linemen. That should help. Considering they always get in the way of our running backs. We're gonna sim these next games. I don't wanna play these next games. We win? I didn't check. We win? No, we lost. Yeah. Tanker season might be dead now. Oh, we're playing on Thursday night. I don't care. Oh, yeah. Oh. I thought that was the copyright one. I don't think this is the copyright one. Maybe it is. Just tackle. That could definitely help. Kicking Next game's kind of, how much time do we have? We have, we got a lot of points in the, we must have won by a lot in the last one if we got that many points. Apparently we got a lot of points in the last one, okay. And we got a new injury. Who's the injury? Why do we have so many injured players? Frick. Well, we won. It's still not completely over. We need to win this game, but I don't really want to play. We don't have enough time to play a full one. Maybe we do, but what we're going to do here is we're going to play a play the moment one and see if Madden can help us win this, because we have not been doing, we've been struggling a lot on offense. What's player personnel? I don't remember what it is. Oh, these are just like better trades. It's not what we need right now. We need better players. Increase X. That sounds pretty good. Alright, our offense is struggling. What can we get on offense to help us out a lot? I feel like blocking really isn't going to do anything. Boost release. That's not going to do a whole lot either. I should just get this again. Boost awareness profit. Let's just, actually, no, I don't really. Sure, let's just get this again. I just don't think that helped too much, but. What else was I supposed to get? Alright, we're gonna play, skip, we're gonna play the moments. So, it should only take us like 5 minutes to play this game. Let's edit their uniforms and make them look stupid again. I think this is their worst one. Where's their worst one? I can't remember. I remember they didn't have, this one's their worst one. Okay. Alright, we're gonna play the moments against this one. We really need to get a win. This is an important one. This is a playoff game.
The Detroit Lions, they look ready to go on offense as we drop you in and get set for the first possession of this contest. Goff on first down.
Well, not the best start if we're going to drop it like that, but maybe we'll figure it out. Yeah, we know. We have everyone out for the season again.
They tell us the same thing every time, don't they?
We're going to need a lot of free agents in order to make this team work.
Be ready to play. That's the mantra of every organization. The key is having guys on the roster who are capable of filling.
I think we need the offensive line. We get pressured every play.
Scouted free agents well and stocked your team just the way you're supposed to.
See what I mean? We get pressured every play. That's the first. That's the first time that's happened in a while. Like, this one really doesn't matter too much. Kind of just comes down to the sim, but it'd be a little bit nicer if sim just was a little nicer to us. Because that was not my fault. Fumble it. On the, if our quarterback decided to fumble it, which they don't even do that much in real life, or I guess Jared Goff does. The better quarterbacks don't. Jared Goff does, probably. It sucks. Why do we train away Jared Goff? Why don't we stick with the only... Yeah, the quarterback we had last year was the only good player on our team. Really decent. We have a good receiver, but it doesn't really matter if we get pressured every play, does it? That's right, it doesn't. It doesn't matter if we do that every play either. Sounds like the Madden sim doesn't appreciate us either. We're dead. Yeah. Our season started out pretty good. We started at 5-3, but right now we're 6-5, and it looks like we're about to lose. We're going to allow 2 touchdowns in the first quarter, it seems. And both of them were not my fault. Both of them were just the Maddens being dumb. Can you at least give us the ball and give us a chance? This might be the only time we're ever going to score. This might be the only time we might score, because I always seem to be able to score during these.
Now Goff on first down.
Come on! Why do the Bears have an eye on like a white dot on their wing? Why does it do that sometimes? Like, I've never seen this happen before. It just happens. It happens. Come on. Well, you caught it, but it doesn't matter because we're dead. That was not good. Alright, after this play, we're going to have to call a timeout. Well, actually, I guess I have to throw an anchor to the defense. Intercepted. Mackenzie Alexander with a pick. Secondaries are not that good. They drop picks. In every other difficulty, they don't drop picks like that in real life always, but they do in Madden. In every other difficulty, I've seen them do it. Okay, the field even in all Madden. Why do you? Hey man, why would you say, hey, you need the field goal? You kind of need it. Nope. Too bad for you. Stupid. Why does the sim do that? Just call timeouts. Don't make me do it. Don't make me think I don't need to call a timeout when I actually do. Don't do that. Third down alert. Too bad. Doesn't matter.
A third down situation coming up in the third quarter in this defense. Hoping to turn that third down into fourth.
Madden sim. Hoping to ruin our game more with our receivers sucking. Could have made that field goal probably, but
it's a third situation in the fourth quarter. Time to see if this defense is up to the task.
We need a really good free agents during free agency after the season, or else we are not. Our offense will not get better. Doesn't even matter. This time it wasn't even my fault. This one was not my fault. This game was us losing it. It was not my fault. It was our receivers dropping it every play, and then one of their defensive players being injured. Not bad. How did he get into the 30 and then end up losing? Give me that. How do you get inside the 30 and not get any points? This thing hates us.
Goff is sacked. DJ Wadham. Credit him with a sack.
I don't care who he is. I don't care that he did this sack. We have the worst offensive line in the league. They're one of the worst. We have one good player. That's it. And we have terrible receivers. We drop it every play. Honestly, I don't even know if this is a receiver's fault. I'm just mad at being stupid. I don't know if we'd be doing good if Madden had better game. Because apparently it did. Because the new Madden thing is that receivers, if they barely get touched, they have to drop it. That's basically a Madden rule. This game, we scored, but it doesn't matter.
The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. Let's just be frank. They're playing for pride at this point.
I know. We should start. We can make the playoffs technically. We need to win every game, and I don't really think our chances would happen. If we're 6-6 and the Vikings are 7-5, we could get the 7 seed, but that's a long shot with how our defense is doing so far. 38, how did that even happen? That wasn't even my fault. That was not my fault. Can we all agree on that? That wasn't my fault. How we lost that game. Let me just look at our stats and see. Yeah, I was recording the Madden Lions franchise rebuild, and look, Jared Goff's fine, although I don't really want to use him again, because this is not good numbers. Rushing has been nothing, which started off decent. Apparently we're doing good, but feels like it's been non-existent. Receiving, it's also been pretty non-existent. Ball. Blocking. We got sacked a lot of times. 14 allowed sacks? He sucks. How do you allow 14 sacks? He allows an average of a couple sacks a game. Apparently our linebackers get the most tackles. Not surprised. Kicking? 71%. It's not that bad. Punting? Whatever. Punters are fine. We don't really care about punting. Kick return average is nothing really. Not anything great either. Let's look at. Do we have anyone on the yearly awards? Let's look at the yearly awards. Do we have anything? MVP. Yeah, not surprised. Coach of the year, probably not either. I think we were in the top 10, depending. Offensive player of the year. Yeah, not surprised. Defensive player of the year. No. No. This is a cornerback that got like 15 picks against the Vikings in the first game, so I guess that kind of makes sense how he might be able to be on there. Offensive rookie. Do we even have any rookies? Defensive rookie. Do we have rookies? I don't know. Do we have any notable rookies? Apparently we do. Best quarterback. Definitely not up there. Best running back. Yeah, we're not up there either. Best receiver, maybe? Like 10th? No. Best lineman. We in the top 10, I'm gonna be mad. D lineman. No. We have one D line. No, that's Panthers. Less linebacker. No. Defensive back. Sure. And the best kicker. Yeah, kickers don't really matter, so. Really, any kicker can win best kicker. No. Yeah. That's it for this video. We seem to be dead out of the playoffs now. If we lose one more, we probably are, but maybe we can win every game. We don't have a very hard game coming up.